Here we are again at Denver International Airport on our way to Orlando for Disney World. As you can see behind me, everything's closed again because we do the overnight flights like we always do. And this time it's February and we are escaping very cold weather in Colorado. It's 10 degrees out there. It's gonna hit the negatives tonight, I think. But in Orlando, tomorrow it'll be 83 degrees and we are really looking forward to that. I actually wore shorts to the airport, even though it was really cold in my car initially. It wasn't too bad once we finally got here. So now I'm warm inside and I'll be in 80 degree weather soon enough. We made it to Orlando International Airport and now we're heading to get our car. Rental car.
Woo!
There's the tree.
Animal Kingdom.
We are a little later than usual and so we weren't one of the first people in the park. It may be bad for us, but we will soon see. Alright, there's all the people in front of us. Not really sure how far back we are. Might not be too bad. We'll have to see. We might just have to amuse ourselves with gorgeous scenery. And the sounds inside. Oh, look, there's Wes everywhere.
Gorgeous scenery.
Oh, yeah. The gorgeous scenery.
And the hottest.
And the strange creatures that inhabit this world. Such as the Westling bird.
He'll randomly shout at things about the deity.
Thank you.
We are waiting. Got some beautiful views.
Let's get over here and then
of Pandora. You've seen these in other vlogs and my own. But oh my goodness. Those flying mountains are awesome. I want one for my living room. Plus, I love waterfalls. And so that big waterfall over there is great. Because it wouldn't kill me to stop and smell the roses or other strange alien plants. And we're moving slowly through the line. Okay, this sign says 60 minutes from where we are. The time is 8:31 right now, so 8:31. We'll see what time we actually get in. Not too bad, I don't think. Maybe it's okay. Usually we're on one of the first rides, but we had to stop for breakfast after the flight got in. And so we got here a little later than usual. Maybe Animal Kingdom wasn't the best choice for the first day, but I think it'll work out. It'll be awesome. Actually, we've reached the turnaround point, so we're all the way down this bridge. Not quite all the way, but now we're turning around and heading back towards the ride.
You guys are really welcome to wait up the rope, but it's
going to
be 25 minutes, so I'm just
trying
to make
sure. Yay! Everyone back to you. We're heading towards the ride. Yay! We're practically on the ride already.
Morning, Sally.
Close up view of the rocks. We don't often go through the standby line, so it's kind of nice to see it from this perspective. 21, 22, 24. There's the floating rocks over there.
That's not a bad. That is the new way.
It's alive! Alive!
It's a pretty cool animatronic, actually. Big blue pod people. Somebody's work desk. Hey look, Dr. Jackie Ogden's book is right there. Yeah, the Ekron connection. Something with the Banshee.
You've all got them. But don't worry, they're very common around these parts. Let's start the decon.
Initiating GMR decon.
Stand still over your number, you're not gonna feel a thing.
I felt that.
You're doing great. Almost done here.
You're all clear.
Great. Now let's go over how all this works. Like I said before, you're going to be matched to these things called avatars, which look a lot like the Na'vi. They're created by blending human DNA and Na'vi DNA. Once we match you to an avatar, thanks to a special link chair, your mind will be able to control that avatar.
Every time I ride that ride, it's spectacular. Every single time. so worth it doing it every single time we come here. I wouldn't wait 4 hours for it, but I really like doing it. All right, on to the rest of the park. We just got out of Up, the Great Bird Adventure with Doug and Russell, who I don't think really add anything to that.
No, but... I really don't.
They're just there so they could call it Up.
Yeah, exactly. But otherwise, the bird show is pretty good. Here are some clips.
Hello, hello, and namaste. My name is Anika. It is beautiful here, yes? Oh, I'll tell you how this place came to be. Many eons ago, there lived an enlightened Maharaja and Maharani of Anandapur, whose hearts were one with nature. So much so that the Maharani turned her palace grounds into a magnificent aviary so she could live among the birds. I am a descendant of that queen, and I have returned to become a caretaker of these wonderful winged creatures from places around the world. Now, nature explorers like you come to place too. That's why my favorite part of each day is when the birds of Olympia join me in a dance to welcome you.
First, when we meet new people, though, we should probably have a bit of a greeting. So let's try that out. Can you say?
Keto always makes us laugh, right, Scott?
Absolutely. And he learned how to mimic really well by listening to the family he used to live with. But along the way, he picked up some really cool animal impressions, too. So what's your favorite?
Ooh, the tiger.
Oh, let's try that one out. How about this? It's a big, scary tiger. What a ferocious tiger.
No. Can Keto do anything tamer?
Something tamer. Okay, let's try this one out. Tigers probably weren't living in the household. Maybe saw that on TV. This one might have been. How about a cute little kitty cat?
Yeah.
Okay, so Keto obviously likes animals. So we thought, how cool would it be to train her to sing an entire song about animals? That'd be a lot of fun. So do you guys want to see if she'll try that song today?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. You ready, Keto? Let's sing.
Got out of the Festival of the Lion King, which we do almost every time we come here because we love it so much. Here's the big finish.
On the
rest of your days. It's a problem free.
And Yeti restaurant where we'll be having lunch today. It's intended to be sort of this, I guess, I don't know if it's supposed to be Indian, Tibetan, sort of a combination. There's quite a bit of different kinds of food in there, themed to that part of the country. We have a reservation. We've eaten here before. We've had their tikka masala, which we always really like. We've had their a bunch of different appetizers, which sometimes that's all we need. But I really like the theming of this place. It's like an old building in Tibet.
Don't eat? Are you going to
And wild? You can see the menu here. We've had the firecracker shrimp, which is absolutely delicious. We've had the lettuce cups, which are also amazing. We've had the wonton soup, which is great. And from the specialties area, we've had the chicken tikka masala. You can see, just like everything with Disney, the prices are a little higher than what you would expect to pay. However, I feel like you could split almost everything on this menu and be fine. So Josh and I will usually split something so that we're not paying for, you know, $20 or $30 each individual person. Okay, Josh and I got the tikka masala and we got wonton soup. And Calvin got the pork belly ramen. Mm-hmm. That looks pretty good.
Yep, it is tasty.
And Wes got the
Ahi tuna nachos.
Alright, we're gonna eat these and then we'll let you know how they were.
Done with the Yak and Yeti. As I mentioned, Josh and I had the chicken tikka masala, and that was very good, like it always is. He had mentioned that it was going to be spicy, which I like spicy, but it didn't actually taste that spicy, so we could have put some sriracha on it and it would have been fine. But otherwise it was fine, and we had the wonton soup. We liked both of those, but we had them before, so we took safe choices. Wes had the
ahi tuna nachos.
What did you think?
They were really good. They were supposed to be for two people, but I was able to finish it off, no problem.
Yeah, I think, because it's an appetizer, so, but you can have it as one person, right?
But, easily. But the biggest problem is I ran out of chips at the end.
Yeah, and the chips are the wonton chip types, not like corn chips, which I actually like. I didn't have any of it, but I like those kinds of chips.
It was really good. It was, it had a little bit of kick to it, like not like super spicy, just enough to be tasty. And the tuna was excellent.
So you recommend it?
I would totally recommend it. I'd eat that again.
Okay. And then Calvin had the pork belly.
Pork belly ramen. The pork belly strips were delicious. The egg was really good. I personally didn't like the noodles. They had kind of a smoky flavor. Not that they weren't bad, just not to my preference. So, you know, if you like smoky noodles, then excellent.
All right, there you go. And it's nice to go with people because I would never order those nachos because I'm not a fish person. And I would never order the pork belly because I'm not that much of a ramen person. So, there you go. Now you have some testimonials. Wes here is a huge Launchpad McQuack fan, and he is a character meet and greet in Dino Land in Animal Kingdom. What'd you think?
It was awesome. It was so much fun. He was awesome.
I'll put some videos and pictures here too.
Yeah, I know. But you know what? You're still rugged, my hands.
Oh, yeah.
So, you got the chin. That's all you really need. You got the hero chin.
Yeah.
Heading over to Expedition Everest. We actually rode it earlier this morning with our fast pass, and we thought we would try it again going through the single rider line so we don't have to wait in the 105 minute line, I think I said it was. Yeah, so single rider. Yes, use single rider when you're here if you don't mind being split up with your party. You're probably not going to have an in-depth conversation while the roller coaster is going on. That's not the time to spring the news on somebody. We left the park and went to check into our hotel, and now we're back at Animal Kingdom. And if you can see behind me, the lines are long to get in. Well, not really, really long, but there's only two lines open. One of them is the annual pass holders, which Josh and I could do, but the others are not. And there's somebody waving in the video back there. So anyway, before we left, we saw the Finding Nemo show, and I'll put some clips here. Our agenda tonight is to do the Navi River journey and to do the safaris and have dinner at Satu'li Canteen.
Remember, all drains lead to the ocean. We got a sink right there and a toilet over there.
Ew.
Besides, you've got your dad out there looking for you. Bet he's on his way right now.
Here's our Satu'li Canteen dinner. I got the chicken with the noodles base, and I got both the onion chimichurri and the creamy herb dressings. Mix that all together. Calvin, what do you have?
Beef with noodles and the same sauce you got, the herb.
Creamy herb. What'd you get over there?
Well, what's left of mine is the beef with the sweet potato and red potato hash.
How was that, the hash?
I love the hash. I love it. With the green onion
chimichurri.
Yeah.
Perfect. And then you got
the blueberry mousse.
Josh, you got the chicken.
Chicken with beans and rice, as well as the creamy herb.
Right, and he also got the blueberry.
Now, the only weird thing about is, do all of them have boba on it? Do every single one have boba on
it? Yeah, they put boba on all of them.
Yeah.
Just like a few little boba pieces.
It's very weird.
Because it makes it look alien.
Yeah.
It's very weird. We're in another planet, remember? Mm-hmm. I got the chocolate cake, which is delicious. Josh and I like to kind of split the two desserts. And yeah, we love this place. Yeah. Amongst us, we got, I think we got all the different bases you can get. No. You got the hash over there, Wes. And Josh got the beans and rice. And Calvin and I got the noodles.
None of us got the shrimp, though.
Nobody got the shrimp. Josh and I had the shrimp last time, and
it's good,
but I like the chicken better.
It's getting dark in the animal kingdom now, and we're heading to the safaris. Along the way, the safaris are located in Africa, the Africa area of animal kingdom. And along the way, we passed a band that was pretty good. Actually, a lot of the acts here are very good. Here's a little sample. And see, it's getting dark. Made our way back to Pandora, and I forgot to answer this question earlier. When we got in line for the rite of passage, it said 60 minutes, and it ended up being about 45 to 50 minutes. So it was close to being right. As you can see, it's very dark here, but behind me you can see some of the illumination of the plants and trees and such. We are on our way out of the Animal Kingdom, Disney's Animal Kingdom. We have to go by the store, and since we did the overnight flight, everyone's exhausted. So we'll get a good night's sleep. And tomorrow morning, we will start in the, actually all day long, we will be in the Magic Kingdom. I'll catch up with you then. Woo, Magic Kingdom!